baby wanna throw my paper out the window. Tell him to have to cut the phone poles. Break my knees so I can move. Cause you a bugaboo, a bugaboo. Hi, it's Jamie, the baby guy. I'm here in my studio apartment, moved furniture out again, because today I have something really, really cool to share with you guys. The new Bugaboo Cameleon 3. Saw this a couple weeks ago. I actually have this in my apartment right now. I'm one of the first people to see it. You know, how many times have you heard people complain about how hard the Bugaboo is to fold, how hard it is to unfold? You see people struggling with it on the streets, getting out of cars, getting out of their trunk. Well, Bugaboo has changed that quite drastically with this new Cameleon. It comes out in September, and it retails at the same price point. It's not going up in price, but for this feature, you'd think it would. Here's the unfold on the new Cameleon. Excuse me, what? Let's do that again. One-handed. Completely different opening. Normally, there are little white tabs here, and they're still here, but you have to squeeze them, drop that down, pull that up, and run. That's how you fold it. And normally, it'd be squeeze that, come up, lock that into place, kick the little bar, and bump that out. But now, Bugaboo has gone and changed it. This is really, really, really cool. You just, you know, I can do it from sitting. Bam. Open. That's not the only change Bugaboo has made with the new Cameleon, but it's certainly, in my opinion, the one that will really, really be the game changer in it, and it will be a huge deciding factor when people are looking at this and other strollers in its class. You still have the high adjustable handle here. You still have the flippable handle, and that really only changes up your wheels. Normally you want the little wheels in the front because they swivel and they're, you know, it's easy to maneuver, it turns on itself. For rougher terrain, you want the bigger wheels in front, because it provides a sturdier ride and it's like a plow. But because they don't swivel, it's a little bit harder to steer. So only use this when you're dealing with rougher terrain, cobblestone, going off-roading, you know, snow. The basket also is different. It used to attach with Velcro onto the frame, and now it actually has snaps. So you just snap it on, and it's really nice. It looks a lot nicer. It's a little bit larger. It's really, really nice. And then you look at the actual frame here, this is a different design now. It's still the same basic thing, but it has this to make it a little bit sturdier. You know, it's a lot smoother when you're flipping it around. Also, the brake is a little different now. It used to be like a multi-stage, click, 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 down. Now, click, done, release, click, just once, bam. So just so you understand the basics of how a Bugaboo works, Bugaboo is basically a modular frame. So you have the chassis here, and you have one big rectangle, and it's an empty rectangle, and then it's slip covers. So you can make it a bassinet if you want, or you can make it this seat. What they changed with the bassinet, and I don't have one with me, so I'll show you on the donkey. This is the slip cover for the donkey. Pretend it's for the Cameleon, it's basically the same thing. With the older Cameleon, you had these plastic blades here. They call them fillets because they're fancy. And you would put these in to get it structure and then have to pull them out when you were folding the bassinet up. Now, these are actually sewn into the frame and you release them with Velcro from the inside. So it allows you to just flip, and this all collapses down in the frame. So it's a lot easier to collapse if you're traveling or storing it. That's the big difference with the bassinet. It has the AeroSleep mattress still. Still a really, really nice feature of the stroller. Now with the seat, the harness inside the seat is different. It's like the donkey seat. The harness height is adjustable by sliding it up and down this webbing here. You know, the fabric here, a little bit durable. durable, you know, it's easy to wipe down. The seat, also a really nice feature, you can just set that on the ground. So if you're going out, your kid can sit in here. There's a weight limit of 37.5 pounds for the Bugaboo. So, you know, you're out, you're at a friend's house, you fold this up, your kid can sit here, so it's almost like a take-along bouncer seat or like a little activity seat. So, you know, you can clip toys onto this carry handle here, the belly bar, and this is also removable, just like that. Very easy to do. Big water-repellent canopy. It comes with your rain shield anyway. And the hand, the seat itself, has three reclining positions. So you have one, two, three. And again, everything on Bugaboo that you'll need to play with is off-white. So think of round, recline, this square pops the frame off. And remember, it's the same on the bassinet and the seat. So this seat also flips both directions. So your baby can look out or look at you, or if you get tired of listening to them, you flip them out. Another really cool feature of the Bugaboo that not many people realize, let's say you're out at a restaurant. You know, baby's in here, you go eat, restaurants are compact, they normally make you fold your stroller up. With this guy, if you have the bigger wheels facing you, you drop the handle down, push this, and then that can go right under the table. So it will be right about table height. Standard tables are around 30 inches. So this is actually pretty good, depending on how tall your child is. And that way the handle isn't jutting out into waiters' ways. They're not gonna like hate you. You won't have to worry about leaving a better tip, even though you probably will because you have a messy kid. And it's not gonna get in the way of foot traffic. So it's a really, really cool feature to be able to just kind of slide this under a seat. And just to show you the fold again, so you know how my preferred method of folding the Bugaboo, I have about 40 different ways. You want to squeeze these little off-white triggers, drop that, catch it on your foot, because that's neoprene. And if you keep dropping neoprene on concrete, it will chip and it can shred, and you don't want that. Then you're going to pop the seat right off, pull that up. So it is two parts when you fold it, but what's nice about that is it actually breaks the weight up. The Cameleon is 20 pounds, so instead of lifting 20 pounds at once into your car, you break this up into pieces. So you're not, it's not as bulky and it's a lot lighter when it's in parts. To open it. Again, crazy easy. Boop. Bam. If you want to take the wheels off, the wheel releases are also a lot better on the new Cameleon. Just these little off-white buttons here. Squeeze it, slides right off. It's terrific. Used to be little like paperclip springs that you had to squeeze, not fun. These are awesome. I love everything about this new Cameleon. I love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. Launches in September. Wait on it, get it. Car seat compatible, you can get your cup holder, you can get your wheel board for the back. It is really, really nice. I'm super excited about it. The new Bugaboo Cam3, C3, like dynamite, Cameleon 3, whatever you want to call it. This stroller is badass. Enjoy. You make me wanna throw my paper out the window. Tell me if you have to cut the phone pole. Break my knees so I can move. 'Cause you a bugaboo, a bugaboo.